Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Today I'm here with Brad with Electric City, and he's going to show us how to properly add an outlet and a light in the attic for a radon fan. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what's involved.
Usually we need power up there in the attic, so usually find a power source close to the location of the radon fan in the attic. This just so happens to be a smoke detector in this case. Other cases it might be a light. Any other junction boxes up in the attic we could also use.
I noticed when you do them in the garage, Brad, that typically you pull power off the garage door opener outlet.
Right. Yep. And new code is it has to be GFCI protected in the attic. So we'll be adding a GFCI protected outlet in the attic.
Okay. So, yeah. So that's where you'll pull your power from?
Yeah, once I'm up in the attic, I'll move it over to wherever we need it. But
you put your outlet in
this place. This is a fairly easy, accessible location to get that power over. Sometimes it's not this easy. Sometimes there's different routes we have to go. But in this case, it's the easiest route.
What's your favorite one to wire? Are the fans outside in the attic or in the garage attic?
I like it being outside. Outside and outside with an unfinished basement.
Yeah.
There again, we can just pretty much tie to anything in the basement, and the fan itself uses minimal. You know, it's like 0.4 amps or something like that. So it's very minimal as far as how much juice it takes. So it's fairly simple. Not a lot of load, not a lot of power being used, but absolutely essential.
I think if I remember correctly, this is 107 watts. So I think it's
the fan.
One and a half amps,
okay.
Something like that.
Okay, they all vary.
This is just a high suction system.
I suppose different amounts of
all sorts of
different size fans, basically, right?
Exactly. Yep.
So
now what?
Now we'll go up in the attic and do the wiring.
Okay.
All right. Well, now we're up in the attic, and my wire's up here. I popped through where that smoke detector was on the main level, and we're just gonna run this over to the vicinity of the radon fan. Install a GFCI protected outlet along with a service light to suffice for our installation here.
Okay, and what kind of wire are you running, Brad?
This circuit is typically it's going to be a 14.2 NM wire. Some cases we'll have to run, and that's good up to 15 amps. It's good on a 15 amp breaker. So typically that's what we'll run into when we tap off of stuff in your living room, hallways, general lighting stuff. Most cases we won't run into 20 amp circuits. That's mostly your kitchen, laundry room, stuff like that.
Okay.
Put a few staples in here to hold the wire in place in certain spots.
Is there anything a homeowner should be aware of if they're hiring an electrician to do this?
Just make sure they're licensed and go through the proper channels, and it's a fairly straightforward job. So
could you explain what might happen if you don't hire a licensed electrician to do it?
Well, you could end up with a you know, they may not install it properly, and you might have a tripping circuit up in your attic, and you may not know, or the outlet may not be working, and and your radon fan not working properly, and you don't know because it's up in your attic, so it's not doing its job, basically. So yeah, I mean, you just want to make sure you get a licensed, approved electrician. Yeah.
Okay. And I believe a radon permit is also required, at least here in Minnesota, or electrical permit.
Yes, there is an electrical permit required, and we are pulling a new wire in the house, so that is requirement by the state.
We get a lot of customers say, hey, I'm going to have my brother-in-law do it, or my dad knows how to do it. Is that okay? Legally speaking?
If it's the homeowner, and they want to do their own work, they can do their own work. They just have to get it inspected and approved.
Okay.
I believe that's the case. But you can't pull the permit and say, I'm going to have Jim do it, and he does it, and you pull the permit. That's not really how it works. If you pull the permit, you got to do the work.
Okay.
And still get it inspected and approved by electrical inspector.
Would that permit and a licensed electrician be for every state? Because we see a lot of other states have the radon contractor wiring the fan. Would that be specific, maybe just to Minnesota?
You know that? I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know the answer to that. I don't want to speak out of turn, because I don't want to give you false information. I just don't know the answer to that.
Yeah. I'll appreciate that.
So the outlet is nothing special about the outlet. It just has to be, you know, within range so you can plug it in without overextending the cord. We're just gonna put it right about here.
Okay.
That's where our outlet will sit.
Yeah, according to the ANSI-R standard, the cord for the radon fan can be no longer than 6 feet, and the disconnect has got to be within eyesight.
And we're gonna have a light right above it in case somebody needs to work on it.
Hopefully not for a long, long time.
The code varies on this. Technically it's a cord and plug device, which means you're not really going to do a lot of service on it, but other inspectors some city inspectors like to see a light up there. Others don't consider it a workable equipment, so they don't really care. We just put a light just to cover both sides.
Yeah.
For the people that care, and the ones that don't care, it's not anything that they're not gonna
I did the same thing working up here. Luckily, I didn't go through the ceiling.
Got a little
particle board isn't too strong.
Didn't go any further down.
Don't put too much trust in particle board.
No.
That's why that first step coming in here is broken.
I have not fallen through a roof yet.
You better knock on some wood. My brother has.
Well, I've heard some people have.
It's a mess.
Fairly simple to do, I'm sure.
Yes.
But yeah, knock on wood. I haven't. As I get a little older, though, it's a little bit harder.
So you just punched a hole in that box to accept your wire, I'm guessing?
Right.
Okay.
Of course. this wire was supposed to be long enough to make it to the light, but it's not going to. So I'll have to run back down and grab some more wire.
Is that something we can have Callie do?
If she can cut it and hand it up to us.
Now he's just running the wire up to the light.
Situation, so.
What's the most challenging part?
If you get like a finished basement or and it's outside, or you know, in this case somehow or some way we're not able to get power up here from something, and we have to go from the panel or somewhere else in the house, and that would be challenging.
The Department of Labor and Industry speak at one of our radon meetings about a year and a half ago.
Mm-hmm.
And he talked about a radon fan is considered serviceable equipment.
Okay.
So that's why he said a light is required in his eyes.
Sure.
But he said, you know, how each building official enforces that is up to them.
Yeah, and it's changed to you know, when I first started and on exteriors, we were simply just putting in the outlet, and the cord and plug served as the disconnecting means.
Yep.
That no longer is the case. We are now putting switches and a GFI out there, and hardwiring the unit itself.
Yeah, I know that's written in the ANSI R standard. No cord like this can be outside. It's got to be in conduit and have a disconnect outside.
Yeah. So that's, and newly is the GFCI protection now is required outside.
And for those of us that don't know what GFCI is, can you explain that?
It's just a ground fault circuit interrupter. Just if it detects any kind of fault in the system, any type of ground, your ground wire touches, or any kind of malfunction inside the equipment, the circuit goes off.
Okay.
And there's many different kinds of... you can get GFI breakers, GFI devices. I've even seen power strips with GFCI protection on them. They're just a...
So I've left some stickers for Brad here. It is required that you label the circuit that the radon fan is on, so he's going to do that here and then on the panel in the garage before he's done. Just says radon fan circuit on it.
And it's not required to be on a dedicated circuit. It's just required to be labeled in the panel.
Yeah, and I believe the standard also says it's no more than 80% of the circuit's capacity.
Sure. So that's about it up here until we come back up and test the outlet and light and make sure everything works.
Okay. And we've got the fan plugged in, so we will know if it works by looking at our YouTube down in the basement.
And I'll also bring a tester up and we'll test it and make sure everything is working adequately.
Okay. And if we don't show the part where we come back up, I'm going to pull all the insulation back once we're done.
Where we started at the original smoke detector, basically we identified the circuit, turned the circuit off, and now we're going to tie the power into our line going up to our radon fan. So we're just going to wire it up. And we did turn the circuit off. That's always a good idea, just to be safe. Don't always need to if you're an electrician, but in this case, it was the safe. It's the safest thing to do at all times for anybody. So, yeah.
I told Jeff his video probably would have gone viral if we let him get shocked, but he did like the sound of that.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't even notice it. I've been shocked so many times that it just kind of just bounces off.
Do you need coffee if you get shocked? Does that kind of do the job of it?
No, I'm just kind of irritated at myself for getting shocked, basically. So yeah, that's about it. We connected our wires. Now we're just going to put the smoke detector back up, go turn the circuit on, identify it in the panel with our sticker, and go upstairs and test it out.
Circuit, basically by turning it off until the circuit had no power. So we know it's this circuit here. We're going to place our radon fan sticker on there, turn it back on, and go upstairs and check it out.
All right, so what I did, we're just about wrapped up. I went up in the attic, tested the GFCI and the light up in the attic, made sure the radon fan was running. Basically, everything was good to go. Light was working, fan was humming, and the GFCI was working properly. So yeah, the next step will be our shop will be in contact with the homeowner of this house or any other house that we do and set up an inspection. Then your electrical inspector will come out. It'll take about 15 minutes. He just wants to make sure everything is on the up and up, and he'll sign off, and that'll be the end of the electric portion.
All right. Well, Brad, thanks for coming out. I'm Jesse with American Radon.
Brad, Electric City.
Thanks for watching.